Good morning. The Treasurer is insisting a newly announced review of the Reserve Bank is designed to build confidence in the institution, not take pot shots. Straight to politics reporter Eliza Edwards in Canberra. Eliza, what's triggered this review?
Well, Charles, there has been increasing criticism levelled at the RBA over its failure to forecast steep interest rate rises and consistently missing its inflation target of 2-3%. But the Treasurer says the first review of the RBA in decades won't be about attributing blame or revisiting history. It'll be about ensuring the central bank is making the right calls into the future. The review will examine whether that inflation target is still appropriate, something Jim Chalmers has an open mind about. It'll also look at the Reserve Bank, what it tells the public and who sits on its board.
I don't want it to be an exercise in pot shots or second guessing. I don't want it to be exclusively focused on a backward looking, blame shifting exercise.
Charles, with inflation and interest rates set to rise even higher in the back end of this year, the Treasurer said he is concerned that the buffers that households have built during the pandemic will start to erode and people may struggle to keep up with larger repayments. But the RBA Governor is making the case that the alternative to rising interest rates would be worse.
Let's just think of the alternative. If we don't have higher interest rates, then we're going to have higher inflation persist. Eventually that will have to be addressed, and we know how, from history, how that's addressed. It's addressed through much higher interest rates.
The Governor said he wouldn't prejudge the outcome of the review due back early next year, but he is pushing for the current inflation target to be kept in place. Charles.
Eliza Edwards opening for us this Wednesday morning. Thank you. There is chaos on Melbourne's roads right now. Tip truck drivers striking as they protest rising fuel costs. Reporter Heidi Murphy is live outside State Parliament where it is noisy. Heidi, they claim they're struggling to make a living.
Yeah, that's right, Charles. Struggling with the rising cost of diesel, and they have been lining up all morning to make their point. They say as the cost of diesel goes up on major government projects, they can't get any more money out of government, and they say that is just not fair. 100 trucks started this off around 8 this morning when they went from the Ring Road over the Westgate Bridge and then into the CBD, where they've been joined by at least 50 more to do laps, including here past Parliament, where they want their feelings to be heard. Under their government contract, they're paid, they're factored in at $1.80 a litre of fuel. They're paying $2.30. The drivers say they need more.
I'm not even making what a normal driver makes. I'm making way less. I'm not taking any money home.
The tip truck drivers are hoping this action today will convince the government to talk to them. They're not ruling out more action in the coming weeks if they don't.
Well done, Heidi. Thank you. To a devastating story in WA now. 3 children have been killed in a house fire in the state's northwest. Let's bring in Nine's Tracy Vo, who's following the story. Trace, we're told that crime scene investigators are now travelling to the town this morning.
Charles, they are on scene as we speak. We've also learned some new details just this morning from the WA Premier, Mark McGowan. The ages of those children, 10 years old, 7 and a 5-month-old baby. We've also just learned that someone is in custody. A truly tragic story that has come out of WA's northwest, Charles. It all happened yesterday afternoon. The fire was reported at 4:45 p.m. It took firefighters more than half an hour to bring that blaze under control. And once they did, fire crews found the bodies of those 3 children inside this home. Now, that road leading to that house, Anderson Street, has been cordoned off for most of the night as local police trace the scene and have a look at that scene since yesterday afternoon. Still no details of the cause of this fire, but we understand that homicide detectives are at the house this morning trying to determine whether this fire was suspicious. We are expecting a further update from WA Police here in Perth. We're going to hear from the Acting Deputy Commissioner to hear further details on this truly horrific story here in WA. Yeah,
Tracy, such a sad story. Thank you. There are several homes, meanwhile, on the outskirts of London that are smouldering wrecks as an unprecedented heatwave sparks wildfires in the UK. Europe correspondent Brett McLeod has this update.
Fire crews are still just mopping up after a day like no other in British history, where we saw fires the likes of which have certainly never been encountered in London, let alone those that ripped through the rest of the UK on a day of unprecedented temperatures. These are the scenes as fires broke out here in this village, just in the eastern outskirts of London. About 300 people live here, and the fire came through their backyards and into those homes, destroying several of them, forcing many to be evacuated. Now, that was just one scene. There were other fires literally ringing London during the afternoon, and many hundreds of others up and down the UK. This because of temperatures reaching for the first time in British history more than 40 degrees. In parts of England, it reached 40.3. London alone was 40.2. Records were set too in Scotland and Wales, both having their hottest day ever. That heat dome has now started to move on. Temperatures have dropped significantly. But forecasters are saying this really is a taste of things to come. This is now the new normal, that England can expect to have the sort of temperatures in summer that we used to in Australia.
A second man has now been charged in connection to the shooting of a young girl in Sydney's south earlier this month. The 9-year-old was hit in the hip when shots were fired into a Connells Point house where a woman and two other children were unpacking groceries from their car. The 21-year-old faces several offences, including shooting with the intent to murder. A 34-year-old has already been charged. A woman is in hospital with serious injuries after a fire ripped through a home in Melbourne's northeast overnight. Emergency services were called to the Doncaster East property just after 3:30 a.m. It is not yet known what caused the blaze. The Prime Minister has just now backed his Health Minister's message of recent days, encouraging people to wear masks and get boosters to help protect against the current wave of COVID cases across the country. He made the comments while on a tour of the Walter and Eliza Hall Institute of Medical Research that's been making antiviral medications for COVID.
Get your booster. Get access to antivirals if you're eligible. Wear a mask if it's appropriate and stay at home if you are sick.
That's the Prime Minister speaking from Melbourne. While the third Omicron wave is growing, 116,000 Australians have had access to antiviral medication, and more than 500,000 have had their fourth booster shot in the last week. Overseas, and three candidates remain in the running to become the next Prime Minister of the United Kingdom. Rising star of the party's right, Cammy Badenoch, was eliminated in the last round of voting and leaves Treasury Secretary Rishi Sunak leading voting amongst MPs, with Trade Minister Penny Mordaunt and Foreign Secretary Liz Truss also in contention. Meanwhile, Boris Johnson has hosted what would likely be his final cabinet meeting before standing down as Prime Minister. Lose a son, buy a car. That's the startling new pro-war campaign being run on Russian state television. It shows family who have lost a son fighting in Ukraine using their compensation money to buy a brand new model Lada. It's hoped the so-called coffin money will help boost conscription numbers there. And it could have come straight from the pages of a script. A crew member working on the TV show Law & Order shot dead on set in Brooklyn. The employee was moving crew cars when a gunman approached and opened fire. His motive isn't clear. Grief is turning to anger in the US city of Uvalde, with families of those killed in the Robb Elementary School shooting furious that nothing has changed in the 2 months since 19 students and two children were gunned down in their classrooms. It follows the release of a damning report calling the police failure to immediately act upon the active shooter a systematic failure.
What are you guys going to do to make sure I don't have to watch my friends die? What are you going to do to make sure I don't have to wait 77 minutes bleeding out on my classroom floor just like my little sister did?
Families of the victims want the police chief to be dumped and better security installed on all campuses. Elton John may soon clock up more farewell tours than John Farnham. The superstar's Farewell Yellow Brick Road tour is headed down under again for encore shows in Melbourne, Sydney and Brisbane next January. The 75-year-old is tacking on the new Australian concerts to the back of his New Zealand tour, which was rescheduled after COVID cancellations in 2020.